Hi folks, and welcome to my tutorial on how to make music with a floppy drive and a Raspberry Pi. First of all, which materials do we need? Of course, you need a Raspberry Pi. I used Raspbian to do it, so it's easiest to follow if you also do. You need an old floppy disk drive. To connect that to a power source, I used a 4.5 volt battery and it worked quite well. But if you have an old power source out of the PC, feel free to use this, it will be a lot easier to connect as you can see later. To connect everything, you need wire which you can cut, so you maybe also need a knife or something like this. If you have jumper wires female to female, it's very easy to connect, but as you can see, mine doesn't look very good but worked quite well, so just be creative with the connection and it will work. A jumper is very helpful to connect two pins of the disk drives, but you can also connect them in other ways. On this picture you can see how to wire everything. If you want a better version, feel free to go to my blog, link in the description. I'm sorry for the bad quality, but I think it still helps a lot. You count the pins from the bottom to the top and from the left to the right, so left button is pin 1, left top pin 2 and so on. Now, as in the picture, connect pins 11 and 12 with the jumper. Also connect pin 18 of the floppy with pin 11 of the Pi and pin 20 of the Pi drive with pin 12 of the Pi. You can read all that on my blog if there's a little bit too fast here. Also connect the right part of the power adapter with the plus of the battery, and that's very important, the left part of power adapter with the minus of the battery, but also with the 6th pin of the Raspberry Pi, which is the ground of the Pi. You need this configuration to let electricity flow through the drive. After you connected everything, the LED of the disk drive should be on. I will show you some pictures of my connection to get an idea how it looks like. I think it's easier to imagine how to do it with these pictures. For the power I use the same colors like in the picture. Red goes with plus, black goes with minus, and then the cable goes on to the ground. So to follow me on this part, I assume you can open a terminal for the Pi, and if you also know how to do some basic file operations, it will be quite easier for you to follow. All commands are also on my blog, so you don't need to type them. First, we need to install wiring Pi, but let's update the Pi with apt-get update and apt-get upgrade first, so everything will work like expected. You need to install git and g++, which we will use later. Use git clone and the link to download wiring Pi and the next two commands to get it installed. You should now have a program called gpio, which we can use to test our configuration. So type GPIO mode 0 out and then the second, and then as you press enter, after the GPIO write 1-1 command, you should hear a light click in your disk drive and you can see the head moving if you have opened the drive. If I were you, I would definitely do this just because of the fun to watch the drive. As you write in GPIO write 1-0 and then GPIO write 1-1, you should hear a click. You can repeat this. If you type GPIO write 01, the head should move in the other direction. So if this works, we can go on to programming too. With MacDia floppy drive, we are creating a new folder and change it to it by CD floppy music. You need a file like main C++ and an editor. I used nano and it opens just by typing nano main.c++. As I used a program I found in a Raspberry Pi forum, just click on the link down to the code and copy everything now. Paste these into the file. If you use PuTTY and a headless Raspberry Pi, just press the right mouse button to paste. Close with Ctrl+C. We now can compile the program with G++, main C++. The L stands for link, so the compiler knows it has to link the wiring Pi library, and the O for output, so we know which file we will get. If you then type /StarWars, you should hear the Star Wars song. If you don't, try to do some troubleshooting, and if you don't know what's wrong or don't understand anything, feel free to leave a comment here or on my blog. I will try to help you if I can. Thank you very much for watching the tutorial. I hope you have as much fun as I have with my floppy drive. And don't forget to like and subscribe or give me tips how I can improve this tutorial to make it easier to understand. Bye.